The opportunity to come here and speak to you students, I think the most wonderful audience and perhaps one of the best people working for oil industry in future. You see, oil industry is going to be developed. Lot of shortage is there in India of oil, and perhaps you are the people who have to come forward to take this opportunity and fill the gap so that we are self-sufficient. Today I will be giving you some glimpses of the project which is to my heart. This is a pipeline project which I did, which is, you must have heard, the heated pipeline, the longest pipeline constructed in India. And this was the project which I started in 2007. You see, we were not aware at all that this heated pipeline, what is at the back you want to do? You want to switch on the lights?
The slide and the same presentation is going on in
back. Okay. So that is the screen light.
Yes.
Okay. Everybody can hear me?
Yes.
So I will be giving you glimpses of this project, because I think this was the toughest project I have done in last 50 years of my association with the hydrocarbon industry. I worked for 37 years with ONGC, especially my time in Bombay High was very tough. But still I think this project, when we thought of, was so difficult it looked like we will never be able to do. But anyhow, this has been done, and what I am going to give you in short is that small presentation that how project was envisaged, how project was carried out, and later on a video movie. Some of you might have seen that, I am not sure, because geographical channel has taken it as a mega project, and they will be showing many times in next 2 years. So this is of course, I am telling you, you might be knowing that kids, I can't see from you. This project, our cane project, Barmer, it is here in India, man. And you see what was our block was, this much big block. Initially, you know that this block was with shell up to 1995 to 2000. Say 2000, came in and they said, okay, we will operate. And Cain started operating. Before that, this Shell had one well drilled where they had hydrocarbon discovery, but it was not commercial. So that is why in 2000, ONGC, this Cain came as operator. And 2004, we purchased the block from Shell. And before that, even when Shell came, ONGC had surveyed this area. Seismic was done, but they did not pursue it much. So from Rajasthan, after finding the discovery, there are 26 discoveries as of today. So first discovery, you know, after how many wells we drilled and we found the discovery? Anyone may not be knowing. See, when you do exploration, the best thing is you pay from your pocket. Government does not reimburse you the money, even after you are doing 10 wells or 12 wells or 13 wells. It is only when you start production, you have commercial discoveries, then government comes in, or even ONGC steps in, to then you are a partner, you can get the money back. So we drilled 16 wells, and total expenditure was about 700 million. Then only on 17th well, which we drilled, we found the commercial discovery in Rajasthan. So at that time, when we found that, thereafter it started that how that will be evacuated, that oil. So this is just a pipeline shown, that it is a pipeline constructed from Barmer up to here. It is Rajasthan, and then it is Gujarat. And these are the red dots showing the refineries are where oil is being supplied. You see, here it is given, when we stepped in, 26 discoveries, and this is the block we have. You see, to envisage the oil line from Barmer, we, when 2007 beginning, we started to think, say, okay, we have found the oil. You know that the oil was very thick, it was not flowing, it was like a coal tar, it was waxy when we found. So how to take it out to the refineries? That was the biggest issue with us at that time. So we started looking worldwide, see what is being done. You know, we did a lot of studies, say whether we can transport this oil by rail. Rail means heated wagons. And railways has agreed that they will give us heated wagons. We thought that we made the project report, one. Second, we thought, can we take it by road tankers, heated road tankers? That project report was made. Then we thought, can we take it by the pipeline? Then that project report was made. So a lot of thinking had gone to assess which is the best way to transport this crude to the refineries or to the different areas. So once these reports were ready, then all the experts, even we sat with ONGC, and then it was decided the best course is that we should go through pipeline. Because you know, road tankers, we cannot transport say 200,000 barrels per day. Railway wagons will take 7 days in coming back to Barmer. So you are waiting when railway wagons will come and when you will load the crude and again it will go. And if there is a strike, there is other things, you are missing the opportunity to transport the oil. So we found out worldwide, so many places heated lines was there, heated line. West, we found similar to ours is 20-inch line which was constructed in 2005. Immediately we sent a team there. They went there, they examined, discussed, found out how it is working. It was working. What main was, its length was only say 160 kilometers or so. Why? We were envisaging 700 kilometers, to be exact 680 kilometers of pipeline. So it was very difficult to take that decision. But anyhow, once decision was taken in 2007, then we started working on this project. You see, to start a project, what is to be done? So first we thought integrated project management team should be formed. So you might be aware, many of you are making projects here. How to run a project? So you do day and night this thing, but we brought on paper. And at that time we hired an international company, JP Kenney, the engineering company, who had done a lot of pipelines, to come with us. And then second thing what we did is, because none of us, neither Kane, nor ONGC, nor anybody else was knowing how to lay this line, heated line, what will be there in the line. So we thought, why not hire people from the worldwide? So you will be astonished to know that we hired 700 years of experience from outside. Means different people. And somebody is having 20 years experience, somebody 30 years, somebody 50 years. So we hired all of them and made a team. This is integrated project team. So that was the first step taken. You see, what was Mangala, this pipeline project? It started from Mangala. Then this is 24-inch pipeline. Then you see, we had a gas in Rageshwari, an 8-inch pipeline along with the main pipeline was to be laid because it required heating. Heating is a very essential part of mainland. So gas was required to generate power. We never depended on, say, state electricity boards or somebody to give us power. Then, say, for generating power, 36 power stations were on way, this project. Every 20 kilometers was a project. And what was thought, even 3 stations simultaneously, if they fail, even then, pipeline will be remain heated at 65 degrees. You see, then intermediate, this Viramgam station, pumping station, because you can't pump from there to 600 kilometers. So this was, then we had a pigging station. You might be knowing what is pigging. To clean the line, pigging stations are there. These are the places, say, refineries where we thought we will supply the crude. SR refinery, Reliance refinery, and near Viramgam, an IOC, and near this place, Radhanpur, where we will supply the crude. Presently, we are supplying at 4 places. One is Radhanpur, one is near Viramgam, another is Reliance, and fourth is SR. Next is, this project is under construction, and very shortly it will be completed. Because this line will be connected to Bhogat offshore terminal. Means you can transport the oil to other countries also for refining, if you want. And why it was necessary? Why we thought of this? Because from Salaya, where all these refineries are finishing, why this is required to go? This is 300 million we were spending on this. But it was necessary because if, say, someday you are not getting the commercial price of your crude, where do we go? So it was thought that let us have an offshore terminal where if we require, we can send anywhere in the Indian refinery through sea or outside the country also. So that was the project. This is brief of the project. You see, this is 680 kilometers of line. And do you know what is ROU? ROU means right of use. right of use, because when you wanted to lay a line, you have to take permission from Government of India. A notification has to come in the gazettes that we are permitting KN and ONGC to lay such and such line from this place to this place. So that is ROU requirement was fulfilled. This is the Government of India's act. And this line is passing through two states, as I told you, Rajasthan and Gujarat, and eight districts and 5,000 land losers. Each one who gives the land for laying of pipeline has to sign the papers. And you might not even envisage. Say, I give an example. One of the person was in jail at that time, and he could not sign, and he could not lay the line in that portion. They were telling signature because government rules, you know. If you don't have a ration card, you will not get the ration from the ration mart. So similar things happened while doing the project, and getting a signature from 5,000 people was a task. You sitting in this room, we cannot envisage how difficult it is. Then is what we promised to the Government of India was that land, the way we take, we have to return to landowners after the job is completed, so that they can do their farming as they were doing earlier. So that was our promise. So now you see the difficulties. Railway crossings were 13. And how do you cross the railways down below? But permission takes 8 to 9 months. And that too, state recommends to the railway board in Bombay, and you have to take Bombay approval. Similarly, national highway, you have to take approval from Delhi. 48 highways were there. Rivers and canal crossings were 232. And other pipelines, say whole country has many pipelines. You have to cross 210 pipelines. Roads, of course, is little easier, 197. So it was a mega, this thing. Here I must tell you, at one of the places in Gujarat, if somebody is from Gujarat, they know a canal is there. So when we wanted to cross that canal, we were told, you have to go about 10 meters below the canal. So 300 feet down below you have to go and cross the canal. There is no other way. We were not knowing what to do now. So then somebody suggested, the funnel company, hey, you have to do like in the sea, etc., you make the tunnels. So we had to get the equipment for tunneling down below. So we made the tunnel down below for crossing that thing. Seismic study, I must tell you, this is like your type of institutes who can do that job. When we were laying, first time in India, we thought, okay, lot of earthquakes are there in the country. So how our pipeline will be? Let us get that study done from Roorkee and Kanpur. So we got it studied. And they showed us four places where we have to take special precautions to lay the pipeline. Otherwise, in earthquake, our pipeline will be dismantled or something will happen. So this has never been done in India. This is the first time ever somebody has thought and actions were taken. Again, river, when you are crossing, you know the water is coming and you can cross it. But we took the data of 100 years old, how the rivers are mitigating their path for last 100 years. And after seeing, that was taken where to cross and how to cross. 36 stations I have told you. Oh,